AEC. We hear this acronym a lot throughout our careers. But what is AEC? Well, it stands for Architecture, Engineering and Construction, but it's a lot more complex than that. In this video, we're going to discuss what AEC truly means, where this industry is headed, and what you can expect as a professional working in these fields. Because a lot of us are unaware of the industry at large despite being a part of it. The AEC industry is the second largest industry in the world, expected to reach an estimated $10.5 trillion by 2023. This makes it one of the fastest growing industries on the planet right now. To understand why, let's dive into the roles of each participant in the industry. The first is the architect. Architects are best known as designers and thinkers. They conceptualize buildings and have a complex role in the construction process from beginning to end. Architecture roles include designers, who meet the clients and create designs best suited to their requirements. Modelers, who create 3D representations of the proposed design to clarify the potential scale of a design and its shortcomings. And finally, planners, who focus on the big picture, city bylaws, community needs, and the impact of construction on surrounding areas. Now let's consider the next link in the chain. Engineers. They've basically been around since the beginning of humanity. Engineers take the concepts developed by architects and turn them into reality. Civil engineers create networks and facilities to make public services such as water, electricity, and transportation available. MEP engineers look into mechanical, electrical, and plumbing services. And structural engineers design the skeletal support systems for buildings, bridges, tunnels, and so on. From site inspections to project budgets, resource coordination, and tracking construction progress, they ensure that the vision of the architect is being executed well. Now we come to the core of the AEC industry, construction professionals. Site managers oversee the day-to-day workings of the site. They hire skilled contractors who bring workers to the building site. Masons are construction professionals who work with materials used for construction, stone, metal, concrete, and tiles to build items the site requires. Finally, construction laborers are responsible for the application of these materials, from unloading them to mixing, pouring, and spreading concrete, digging and filling holes and trenches. They are also responsible for cleaning and adding final touches to the finished building. All these stakeholders combine their unique talents and create a finished product that ties together the ecosystem. The building process, from the architect to the engineer and to the construction worker, comes full circle. As for where the industry is headed, AEC is largely impacted by current trends, including the green revolution, data management, and remote work enabled by digitalization. Digitalization has, in fact, completely changed the way the industry operates. Workflows are now way more efficient, and individuals' productivity is also much higher thanks to new age tools. And firms around the world are actively seeking professionals who are trained in skills like BIM and computational design to drive digital innovation further. Especially since the pandemic, it has become clear that archaic solutions and non-digital interfaces will not suffice for the industry anymore. So if you're an AEC professional looking to make an impact in the industry while also forging a rewarding career path, upskilling in digital tools is the way to go. We have previously done a video on what the most high-paying jobs in AEC are, so do remember to check it out. The link is in the description below. So that's it. We hope this video gave you the insight you needed into the AEC field. If you would like to learn the industry-relevant digital skills of today, remember to check out our website, 1is2x.com, to kickstart your learning journey. Subscribe to 1is2x's Instagram and YouTube for more such insights.